Hello, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing the middle of the month love reading for all zodiac signs. This is going to be for Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. We're going to do this a little bit different. We're going to be using two different decks, one for you, one to represent your person or a person of interest. Before we get into your reading, Virgo, I just want to give you guys a quick update. We're going to be releasing and launching on Friday, May 21st, 2021, which is next week on Friday. As you guys can see here, we have the pendulum gift box set. It is a pendulum. Obviously, you guys know what it is. If you don't, maybe it's not for you. For those that are interested, these are ritualized and consecrated pendulums that have been specifically charged for your protection, only to connect and communicate with your spirit guides and ancestors. It also comes with a necklace and a vial that has protection stones and herbs in it to facilitate the communication. So if you guys are interested, definitely check that out. Like I said, next week, Friday, May 21st. We only did a limited amount. You guys know that I'd like to make my things extremely personal, and I ritualized and consecrated through ceremonial magic each one of these pendulums and the jars and the necklaces. So we only did, I believe 50. Yeah, 50. So those are the only ones that we're going to be releasing on Friday. So I guess first come, first serve, just letting you guys know. All right, let's get into your reading, Virgo. Let's see what spirit has for you guys for this month of May 2021 in regards to love and romance. Spirit guides, please give us a vivid picture of what is unfolding for Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus in regards to love and romance. Guide them on their journey towards answers, removing any doubts or any fears. Thank you, spirit guides. All right, let's get into it. Quick side note, you guys, ignore my nails. We have been extremely busy with spell work, with consultation. It's just been so crazy. I don't know if you guys are experiencing this chaotic energy as well, but it almost feels like we don't have enough time. Sleeping 2-3 hours a day, and it still feels like I just cannot keep up. I'm blessed and thankful, but anyways, just letting you guys know. Yeah, ignore my nails. I have not been able to go out and get my nails done. I've been so busy. Anyways, let's get into your reading. Sorry, just wanted to put that out there because they look like shit. Okay, so we have the Queen of Pentacles, the Eight of Swords, the Five of Pentacles, the Two of Pentacles, the Queen of Cups, and the Six of Pentacles. Okay, Virgo, what the hell is going on with you guys? I see you guys really putting effort and energy towards a specific person. This could be a water energy, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. It doesn't have to be their sun sign. It is just the energy that they're currently vibrating to. I feel like the Queen of Cups is in reverse, though, so it's definitely a very manipulative type of energy. This could be a person that is extremely selfish. They only think of themselves. It could be that they come to you, they reach out to you whenever they're, you know, not doing good, when they're not thriving, when they're not at their best. That's when they contact you. That's when they come back in. That's when they try to communicate. That's when they try to prove to you or tell you that you mean something to them. But with the Eight of Swords here, I feel that you guys are feeling mentally stuck in this situation, and it could be almost the situation that you continuously keep dealing with. It's almost like they come and they go. There is inconsistency here. What spirit is telling you is that you need to take your power back, Virgo. Stop putting effort and energy towards people that don't deserve your energy. And this is not just in love and romance. They're telling me this is friends, this is family members. These are people that genuinely rely on you. Now, this could be emotional, financial, or even physical support. You know, if they're not getting their needs met somewhere else, they come, they reach out to you. Like, stop doing that cycle. With the Five of Pentacles, there's almost like there is a disconnect in this connection or the person that you're dealing with. It's like I said, it's definitely, it's a give, 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 and there is no take on your part, Virgo. And this has you feeling very emotional. This has you feeling, even questioning your self-worth, or like, what is it that I'm doing wrong? I keep putting effort and they just keep like even ghosting you, and then they come back all of a sudden, and what they're telling you here is stop wasting your precious, unique, loving, overdoing ass to someone that is a complete douche or a complete bitch. Like, stop wasting your time. People that are very selfish, people that only take, people that don't reciprocate, you know, it's kind of like what I'm getting is like, I'm seeing my cell phone turn on, and it's like, I'm looking at the time and it's like 3:20 in the morning. And it's almost the feeling like whenever they reach out, doesn't matter the time, the day, whatever, you could be busy as hell and you still respond to them. And that energy has to be reciprocated, and it's not. So it's time for you to stop wasting or putting effort and energy towards those that are just, all they do is take, and they're exhausting your energy as well. Six of Pentacles, you need to be careful, Virgo. If you guys are doing good financially, like, stay in that power, but stop overdoing. Stop telling your friends, oh, I got you. You know, they bring up, oh, I don't have money, or I'm not doing good. Oh, I got you. Like, you know, I'm hearing, I got you. Like, no, stop doing that. Focus on you, on nurturing yourself, on, yeah, you want to be living your best life. That's fine, and do it, but do it for yourself, baby. Don't do it for other people. Don't make it easy for other people. There's almost like this feeling of stop announcing your moves. Stop announcing what you're doing, because it's only like them wanting to be around you or coming around you when they see that you're thriving. And that's when you're supposed to be much more mindful of your energy and who you decide to deal with. This is definitely like, I feel that this person really toys or plays with your emotions, and you need to stand your ground in that, Virgo. Stop allowing them to feel like they have control over you, because they don't. The moment you take your fucking power back is the moment they no longer have the cards to play. They no longer have power or control over you. It's kind of like the narcissistic type of energy that I'm sensing. A person that, you know, is so narcissistic, they only think of themselves. They only care about themselves. But what happens when you ignore a narcissist? It completely drives them bonkers. Why? Because they're so used to manipulating people emotionally. So you need to stop doing that. Allowing them to do that anyways. All right. Let's see. We have the Moon card here. These are the cards that represent the person that you're currently dealing with. The Eight of Wands, the Judgment card, Four of Swords, Two of Pentacles in reverse, which, by the way, I don't do reversals. Spirit will let me know if they are in reverse. For some reason, they don't want me to ignore this message. So what they're telling you here is thrive and really embrace your single life, Virgo. So what I mean by that is you need to, like, if you're in the talking stages with someone, like, don't be loyal to them. Like, point blank. Don't be loyal to them. Don't sit there and, like, you know, try to act like you're in a relationship when you guys are just in the talking stages. Why? Because they are assuming that's how you are, right? A loyal person, which is good. But when getting to know someone, it's kind of like they are thinking or assuming that you're predictable. You don't want that. You got to let them know, like, hey, you know, that's how people decide if they want to be with you in a relationship, if they want to commit to you. Why? The fear of you entertaining other people. That's what the dating scene is for. So again, stop committing to people that are not non-committal to you. Now, this person is really like, this is the person you've been dealing with, or the person you're interested in, is really like, they love to be single. They're not looking for any type of commitment. With the Judgment and the Two of Pentacles, this is a person that keeps going to the past, and then they wonder why they can't move on, or why they're not doing good, or why, you know, they can't be in a serious relationship. And the reason for it is because they're still holding on to someone from the past. They haven't released that, or they still refuse to acknowledge that it's time to move on. They keep entertaining the past, all the while being consciously in balance, meaning fuckery type of energy. Eight of Wands, they communicate with the Moon card. Again, they communicate whenever they feel like it, whenever the moment, whenever they're in their feelings or they feel lonely or they're not getting attention, that's when they come back and they try to communicate with you. Four of Swords here, you need to stop dealing with this person. You need to see things for what they really are and stop wasting your time. Know without a doubt, Virgo, that you are the Nine of Pentacles. You are a person that works hard towards achieving their goals. You're a person that is really worthy of commitment or worthy of being taken serious. But it starts with the way you allow people to treat you. So again, I feel that this person definitely sees that you're doing good. It could be the reason why they're coming back around. It's kind of like that fuckboy type of energy that I'm sensing where they see you moving on and then they try to reach out to see if the feelings that you had for them will resurface, only to play and toy with your emotions. Stop giving into that type of energy, Virgo. All right, my lovelies, I hope that this gives you some type of insight, some type of understanding. Like, share, and comment, and we will see each other soon. Till then, I'll see you guys soon. Bye.